Welcome everyone to a little gadget update here between the videos, and some frustration is the usual thing. AMD availability of latest and greatest mobile parts still waiting, recurring viewers still. Yeah, the problem is 7-year-old Retina MacBook Pro. I still would use it some more years, but live streaming here from not in the office, a little bit annoying. You see the fans already in hyperventilation mode. So yeah, super frustrating. I wait already a couple of months. ThinkPad X13 Gen 2, apparently all the silicon goes to PS5 and stuff. So yeah, coming soon. With this, I was looking to alternatives and was looking to this Dell XPS. And yes, that is Intel. And a recurring theme, right? I think I mentioned this already some year ago. I really don't understand what is wrong with this PC vendors there and their bloody Nvidia SKUs. If you look here, I mean, first of all, PC vendors, right? It's like 13, 13 new, 15, 15 new. It's like, seriously, what the heck? Also, you could use like proper model names there or something. But anyway, the point is, it's like, yeah, okay, fine, maybe Dell X13, maybe 15 inches, a little bit with this ultra slim bezel, maybe that is nice. But so if I want to get a better display, the issue here is that they force this bloody Nvidia graphic down my wallet. And I don't want this, right? Not even for battery efficiency and, yeah, a few grams of the silicon certainly don't matter, but silicon efficiency plus certainly is a super annoying Linux driver situation. I don't buy something that I know there is no or barely, certainly no signed firmware open source driver thing. But yeah, full HD plus is like, yeah, thank you very much. OLED, it's like, yeah, switching to Nvidia graphic there. Or UHD plus. Is that even the same resolution? Oh, actually, this is funny. This is also not the same. Anyway, not the same resolution, yeah, but all the high DPI options. And from the hardware, I would think this should be perfectly fine to drive this display there. It's either, I mean, I can understand they don't want to have so many SKUs in stock, but yeah, look at all this stuff. It's probably custom built anyway. They certainly don't have like stock. This is certainly just in time manufactured. So from that point, I would not think there should be a reason, or if there really is a physical reason that the connectors are not the same, that they only, by the way, do you get the other display? No, look at this. I mean the low end display you get together with the Nvidia. So I don't think it should be like physical limitation. I mean, this, truth be told, sure, the Intel graphic is not the most outstanding, but it's of course perfectly fine, especially with 2D stuff, desktop stuff, or hardware composite 3 desktop stuff to drive this resolution. Other machines do that fine. So as far as I can see, it's mostly like my top guess, and they just want to make more money, right? And at this, like, hundreds. By the way, how much is it? Can you just select that without... No, other stuff is changing. And also, let's... Wait a second. So this is funny. You also, if you change more memory, you also get Nvidia graphics. Does it mean... the thing is you don't... wait a second. This didn't register. So this means that... Apparently... And this confusing, I didn't even realize this before, but maybe more than 8 gigs of memory, you also get the bloody Nvidia graphics. But yeah, recurring theme last year, a decade ago, recurring theme, greetings from your PC vendor, showing your finger. It's like, yeah, confusing SKUs, and it's like, yeah, also probably soldered. I mean, this is already a fallback option, right? Likely soldered memory, not like on some other laptops where you can swap this out. So yeah, frustration galore. Even more frustrating than initially imagined of, yeah. Anyway, more amazing news. The reviewer, and I made a live stream some months ago, this framework modular laptop, and this is exactly the thing, the counterpart to this bloody Dell configuration, right? Where you can actually bring your own memory. It is not soldered. You can bring your SSD, and the reviewer in from Linus Tech Tips to Engadget and Ars Technica and stuff. And most reviews, especially Linus Tech Tips and stuff, agree. They totally like it. Repairability, certainly. Linus Tech Tips and stuff, prosumers and stuff, more pro users. They all loved it for the most part. I have to say, in Linus' video, it looked a little bit more sturdy than I would expect it. I expected to have a little bit more flex and stuff, so that is certainly good. They mentioned here at Ars Technica, the ugly only, I mean, even they say delivers on its promises, and it's a winner or so. The only ugly 61% of the battery life of similar configured XPS 13, so yeah, but I don't run my laptop like 8-10 hours if battery life 6 hours, so 10 hours is anyway if you barely do something, right, stare on a blinking cursor or something. So for me that's fine. I take all the configurability and 3x2 display and so on. The display still not met, but maybe there will be more display options in the future. I anyway take all the modular options and configurability over all the soldered and bloody NVIDIA graphics any day. So a lot of goods, ultra slim. Well, I don't need ultra slim. I don't need that lightweight, but it even is that so much to big vendors like Apple of like, yeah, we can't build repairable and modular ultra thin and lightweights. Like, yeah, even some startup can. So there is that myth busted. Easily the most repairable laptop. So I wonder, previously positive shout out, X13 not still coming, still not there, maybe it is in a month or something. Other vendors like Dell XPS 15 is like, yeah, the SKUs are not for me, so 8 gigs of memory not for me, NVIDIA graphic also total no-go, so maybe someone at Dell should be sitting here and writing this down to sell more stuff to PC enthusiasts and Linux developers. Sharp, vibrant, bright display, high quality components, choices, Western Digital, black NVMe, Intel Wi-Fi, all stuff that is high performance and works well in Linux, modular I/O base, USB charging, the displays 3x2, just how we love it here for the more vertical display screen real estate. And yeah, some not amazing stuff, only one USB module was included. Yeah, also I wouldn't say, yeah, take this reviews always with a grain of salt and match this to your own expectations. I don't need that much USB-A, and it doesn't have so many. I think it maybe has 4 bays or something. So included in this DIY kit, I think one is fine. Many like Dell XPS maybe or others don't even have USB-A anymore, or Apple. So one USB module, what they mean is, here's those modules at the bottom to plug in stuff here. Like probably those here, yeah, those USB-C connected expansion parts, and this stuff is even nicely labeled. So yeah, for all those who didn't know how memory looks and stuff, so yeah, this is memory. You can bring your own, and by the way, they are hiring, and these are the serial numbers and spare part numbers and stuff, and yeah, good stuff. And I mostly wonder whether I should simply wait here, support this company. For me, I can't just order because this US layout would get on my nerves. I can work with that, but it's not super, super amazing for me here in Europe. So they want to ship Europe, although this has this. Oh no, this is, no, I need this. Yeah, end of the year, hopefully for ISO layout keyboards, maybe I should just wait longer, certainly more environmentally friendly to use this falling apart Retina MacBook Pro. Anyway, one more tip. Even this Huawei here, MateView, newsworthy due to the nature, recurring theme here, not a fan of this ultra-wide displays. They simply have mostly no use for me. I simply prefer 16x10 or 3x2, this new, well, 16x10 historic format before the industry went movie watching crazy. And this is a rare skew here of 3x2 displays that otherwise only found in some outstanding laptops and Microsoft Surface Studio. Very few, next to no display 3x2, and it's also not perfect. So the price is okay-ish, $800, 650, 700 euro. However, for me, first of all, it's a little bit too large, but I would probably live with a 28 inch. It's probably at the border, 24 inch, 25 would be enough for me. Maybe I get it anyway, a little bit larger, okay, fine. Not the ideal match for me for the resolution, probably with 200% high DPI scaling, but maybe I give it a try. The only other thing is here this wireless projector. So it comes with Wi-Fi, so it has a little bit feature creep that I don't need, I will probably never use, and I also don't like to buy products like having like a display should be display, and like, yeah, who probably ever uses this wireless stuff for presentations? Like, yeah, for me a display is like one mostly connected device and not like random people connecting Wi-Fi display presentation wise. I could understand this with some projector beamer there in your conference room. This is display, not really so much. Not sure if this is some maybe smartphone use case, although I would think maybe the display lag is way too much to even use this as a smartphone tablet display connect replacement. So from that point, yeah, somewhat security environment here with Linux and security stuff, maybe I would still use it without wireless, but it's just out of principle buying devices that have random stuff that I don't want. And then I always wish the stuff for sure costs at least $20, maybe plus some R&D and licensing cost, who knows, whatever. But I simply wish they would have used this for making the display better, for example. But yeah, this is always some more thing. The industry is more freezing, higher refresh rates, and for that it isn't that right. For me, with YouTube content creation and stuff, I would like to have a freezing display, so I would rather see this having at least like 100 hertz or 140 or something, at least, or 100, yeah, like double of 60 or something, 120 hertz, instead of this bloody wireless projector. But that is just complaining on a high level. The problem is, as I said, very few 16x10 or even 3x2 displays. So maybe I get it just for the 3x2 display, because being realistic, there will probably be very few other similar displays. Otherwise, I didn't find immediately where the power supply is. I have the feeling the power supply is a wall wart there, not ideal. I would also prefer the power supply PSU in the monitor stand or something, instead of, yeah, similar to the, what is it, iMac. Complaining on a high level, I just don't like having even more stuff I have already, like logic analyzer, and my desk usually has a lot of stuff, and then even more power supply, like each thing of some FPGA board here, some prototype device there, some embedded board there, and then this dangling, that it's just too much. Sure, other people always say like, yeah, but this one power supply is like, yeah, there is already, usually as seen here on this video, is too much on my desk. What else is here? So screen to, yeah, I mean, screen to body ratio, who cares? 98% DCI, also somewhat color occurrent maybe, but some website headsets is not the most evenly lit, so yeah, whatever. So for the price, probably it is quite fine. It's just not high refresh rate. It's the most evenly lit, probably, and other stuff. I think it has speaker though built in, probably, right? Maybe there, but whatever. You get the idea. As usual, just a little bit update of maybe useful stuff, or especially if you fall back to other options because other stuff is still not shipping. Look on the configuration fine print and what you're ordering, like, yeah, selecting something and stuff like NVIDIA jumping in there that you didn't expect. And otherwise, leave in the comments below what you think. Maybe framework laptop, giving that a try and supporting this. And by the way, this is a 3x2 display, right? Probably didn't mention that. That is certainly a welcome, yeah, 3x2. Also, why is it listing on the bed 3x2 if you're not into that? But anyway, leave in the comments below if you find this shout out useful. I hope a little bit of not as often seen devices. Oops, this is also not as often used mouse wheel here. This was actually not intentional, just mouse wheel on the title bar. I probably should disable this feature that I never use. Anyway, that's it for the video. Let's see, do we have some people tuning in? Comfortably numb, you seriously have an OnlyFans account? Yes, we had a questionnaire. I think so far nobody, still we are very sad here that nobody signed up there. We had a questionnaire and people really voted for that. I think this was 60%, but yeah, so much to trolls voting for the fun of it. But I think they want to become more serious, so probably in some years' time this will probably still be the becomes a favorite way to support open source developers. Previous video. Evergreen says only a 55 watt battery is a deal breaker, should have gone with 95. Do you mean, and welcome Anthony Sinnett, you probably mean the framework, right? Do they have here a watt hour, maybe battery? Framework configure 28 TDP. What is their battery life here though? I mean, they are here somewhere, Walmart there. So again, how much, so this is minutes. So this is still quite respectable, right? I mean, it is less here than other devices. However, for modular, this modular components take some extra space. And not glued in battery, some millimeter there. For me, personally, I don't use it that much disconnected. And then for flights and traveling, planes and trains and airplanes and stuff, if not to say cars and hotels and conferences, you usually eventually can plug this in. So this is still 9 hours, right? 10 hours, 600 would be 10 hours. So this looks still relatively good to me, but I understand, but you can't have the cake and eat it too, right? So from that, similar to the display, and there is, like, this is Dell SKU, right? There's somehow always something, some people will always, you will always find some people who will not be happy, like myself here. I would, however, say, in the case of this Dell XPS 15, and I think I checked the 17, that was the same thing, 17 new, and probably also the old SKUs. I'm pretty sure it was, also, yeah, this is crazy, right? Who wants a 17 inch with full HD resolution? I mean, a totally nonsense SKU, right? I mean, why do companies even offer such a bloody nonsense? Hey, but here you get, you know what? Maybe I should order this one, but it could be sometimes Dell, I think I checked that, and maybe they didn't have this in Germany. Sometimes they don't have previous video all SKUs in all of the world. Or maybe I should also because first of all I want input VAT, and second of all I want a German keyboard. That is at times an issue. Can we load this? Let's double check that. No, we want to stay in Germany. Is this the... Maybe we need that one of all the crazy... Wait, the new is cheaper than... 1000... Hello, not... Can I also toggle to... Hello? No, it doesn't toggle now, whatever. Yes, that's it, all this bullshit. So let's configure our own... hello? What is it? Details, whatever. Yeah, websites, what should I... Why does this configurator look differently? Accidentally, where is the display? Yeah, okay, need to check this later. However, this might have been the problem. How much memory can we add before they... Yeah, okay, you add a little bit of memory and they switch to this is simply crazy. Maybe this was the issue. So same issue. I mean, it is crazy that, I mean, you can, this is so crazy, right? Ultra HD with 8 gigs. I mean, seriously. Maybe I should resort to other people on Twitter. I saw some people, they, with hot air soldering skills, they seriously unsoldered their memory, patched their BIOS. Maybe they had to patch it. This is a problem, right? You can't just unsolder this. At times it needs BIOS support, right? But yeah, the crazy SKU stuff here continues. Who wants, I mean, you can at least match this so much to the theory I previously mentioned. The bloody Intel Core i7 can easily drive that. So even here, Dell proving my point. This is possible, but why with 8 gigs of memory, right? This is so crazy. Can we toggle this back to... Hey, wait, this... Oh no, this is... What, why did this... Did this just change back to full HD? Ah, then it changes to another NVIDIA SKU. Wait, what, when, if you change that... What is jumping around? Ah, if you choose that, ah, then that becomes grayed out and you can't... No, I get that. Okay, at least they show here a little bit what configurations are possible. So that is why, so that is what this gray means, okay. Now I got that usability. But yeah, crazy, crazy SKUs here. Ultra HD Plus with 8 gigs of memory and why? This is so stupid. I have no words. I have no words. And just underlying why I made this video and proving the point here of completely useless, insane... Excuse me, but honestly, they should also simply stop. These are relatively high-end SKUs, even starting with the XPS line itself, and there should simply not be an 8 gig SKU anymore, right? I mean, 8 gigs UHD, and they take perfectly usable SKUs that professional, especially Linux users, would want, and they don't exist. It's crazy. Maybe better go with this repair friendly modular startups and support this trend. Can much more recommend this than this old fashioned stuff. Old fashioned business. And this is also innovation, right? How new startups like Framework can easily beat, at least for many prosumers, this kind of configurations and options, and also the soldering to the PCB nonsense. Even Hector Martin there of PS3 Hacking and ARM Linux there on Apple M1 fame mentioned he like supports this for the power because he is an electrical engineer, is quoting this from my summary, from my memories. Socketed memory means more energy consumption, but I would say, you know what, how much is it in the core scheme of Intel and NVIDIA graphics and display and stuff? So I mean, what is 1 to even if it's 3%, it's certainly not like 50%. Your socketed memory does not consume like mountains of more electrons. So I would rather, basically, is this the thing of soldering the memory hurting the vendors? Because if it wouldn't be soldered, I could just plug in my own memory, bring my own memory, and not rely on this stupid excuse here. This, yeah. But as usual, leave in the comments below what you think. Evergreen, right? They decided to go for SIM instead of battery. Yeah, I mean, I totally agree with that. That is certainly a conclusion of that. For me, as I said, I basically said the same initially when I said I don't need ultra light and thin, but maybe I would also take, and I said this so many times, including bloody Apple iPhones, I rather take a millimeter or two more and have like significantly, because that is such a volume, right, over the whole area of the device. And yeah, totally agree. Give me 2 millimeters more. That is not the world. And I rather take another 3 hours or so of battery life. However, maybe they intentionally wanted that not to have reviews point out it's thick and clumsy. So again, for me, battery life is enough. And maybe they wanted more positive reviews from the thin and ultralight focused PC review industry and YouTubers, and not have all their sales killed. Because as it from Linus Tech Tips to Ars Technica, everyone is mostly praising that. And if it would not have been that thin, maybe the reviews would be differently, not calling it a winner. That's it for this video. As always, looking for your comments. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And also let me know in the comments below if you prefer this light white tech updates here in the middle of the day, between the more productive videos. And I hope to see you soon for more low level stuff to come.